We are in Muscle Shoals, Alabama at the famous, the legendary Fame Studios.
This place is hallowed ground right here. I mean, it was responsible for some of the most prized songs of the 60s and 70s. I mean, you got hits from Otis Redding.
Percy Sledge.
Wilson Pickett.
The Allman Brothers.
Aretha Franklin.
One word, Aretha. I mean, there's a lot of other ones, but like, Aretha.
There's a handful of studios like it, famous around the world, you know, Abbey Road, Muscle Shoals, Stax.
One of the premier recording studios in this country, dare I say the world.
A lot of history has been made here. You can tell shit went down here.
Like, I remember hearing a ton of the songs that were recorded here just like in my parents' car growing up on the radio.
So we're here to strip things down, kind of give a new perspective on some songs. We don't really know where things are gonna go.
We're here to make some music. We're here to share some more love with the world, to capture some more vibes.
You know, kind of take that with us and see if it helps us do what we do.
Okay, so you know how the chorus stays in A minor?
Yeah.
So it brings more of a joyous sound to it. I want to bring out the joy in the tune, because there's a lot that I feel like we're missing from the other version. I think we can do it in this version.
Like, are the drums still going at it?
Yeah, the drums and bass. It's just basically piano, dobro, drums and bass, and vocals and some claps.
Yeah. Yeah, that's tight.
Better without the ace.
Almost better, like maybe even a cappella, but if
actually, let's do it a cappella.
Three, four.
All my friends take good care of me. Wherever I go, it brings me home. Ain't got no place to be. All my friends take good care of me. It gives me heart, it's on my side, as far as I can see. Yeah. I'm in my 20s, living reckless. So turn the hourglass over and let's wreck this. It's a brand new world, I got a brand new heart. And every day I get that brand new start. I'm in my 20s, not in a hurry. I got a bulletproof chest so you can hurt me. It's a brand new world, I got a brand new heart. And every day I get that brand new start.
I think people come here because they want to get that certain kind of vibe and sound.
We wanted to do some different versions of songs here, and we kind of thought that this place could bring out the best in these different versions that we wanted to create.
When you come to a place like this, it makes you step up. It makes you play differently. Knowing that this is where some of the greatest recordings ever have been made definitely makes you focus. I mean, I'm playing drums that have been here since the 60s, and hitting them makes me want to play in a more soulful kind of way.
There's just a feeling that you get kind of stepping into this legacy. Like, there's a certain sense of responsibility you have when you think about people who've come before you in certain places and what you're trying to do. And so to come into a place like this where we're just standing in the footprints of so many titans, it's an honor and it's a responsibility, and you know, it's also just a lot of fun.
I'm trying to hear a line. If it was that, yeah, that. The dobro's gonna take into that ghouly, ghostly thing. What are we? How slow are we working out? Are we making this thing?
Yeah, try really some finger picking.
Like, I don't hear drums going with this. You know what I mean?
Definitely not.
Yeah. Like, this would just be you and Zach almost. It looks like this. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Actually.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think it's pretty cool.
What is the Muscle Shoals sound? That's the question. You could say it's the room, you could say it's the console, you could say it's the instrument. I really think it's the musician.
And I always wonder if it's a chicken or the egg thing, if it's, you know, everybody coming through and leaving like a bit of essence or aura, or if the place has the kind of aura that makes that essence and helps those people become who they were.
I mean, anytime you get into a historical place like this, you can just feel it. I don't know what it is, you just feel it.
They haven't changed anything they've done here for so long, and it works, and it's part of the allure of the place.
It has that sound. I can't make that sound quite so easily at my house or in another studio. That is the soul sound.
When I hear that in the ears, it's just like, so it just makes me, like, my hairs stand up on my, you know, arms when I hear it.
Got it? Lifting me up, pulling me out when I'm with you.
Let's try it, boys.
Now I don't know if I really should have done it, but I did it anyway. Now I don't know if I really want to do it, but I do it.
Just the fact that we have eight of us and we're a fairly democratic band, there can be a little bit sometimes of a case of too many cooks, but it's kind of a beautiful chaos.
Hey, did you guys gain up the steel towards the end there? Because it jumped in my earphone, my headphones a lot. Or is that just the same?
When it comes in with the...
When it gets quiet, yeah, exactly.
Cool, dude.
Do you want to do another
Let's
take?
Do it one more time and then just move right on.
Last take. Just like, if you are around the first pre-chorus.
First pre-chorus?
Yeah. Take me to real love. It's
pulling me out when I'm with you. We like that, right? Last take.
I'm down with that, yeah.
We just have to, you know, if we're trying to do this whole album, we have to, like,
we gotta go.
We gotta keep going.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't do five verses of 14 songs, like, and have my voice tomorrow.
Sure. Keep moving on.
That's sort of like a structural important thing for our group to be able to say, oh, I had this idea, I wanted to do something like this, and you don't get shot down because it's not like what we did before. It's just, oh, is it good? Do we like it?
We're getting better, you know, listening to ourselves, listening to each other. You know, it's all about communication. It's all about give and take. It's all about ebb and flow.
I'm going. Okay, that's cool.
And I think our sound has kind of evolved along the way with us.
All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Certain kind of light never shone on me. Why wouldn't my life to be lived with you? Lived with you. And there's a way. Everybody says, do each and every.
got you.
Play with somebody for a decade, you really get the vibe of what they provide. Or, you know, everybody knows their part, they know what to do. We've gotten very good at playing with each other.
When you've played together for 10 years, you've kind of grown as musicians, and you've grown to fill each other's gaps.
We're doing a new version here. You're used to playing it a certain way, and methodically, you want to go to where you've already gone. So it can be a little difficult when you're trying to spark something new out of something you've already created.
It's always from the heart. I mean, I think that's the best art. I'm just trying to make people feel something, and hopefully I do something that is original.
Two strangers in the bright light. Wish I knew you. Wish I knew you. Oh, wish I knew you when I was young.
Come in a little closer real quick. Yeah, I can hear you guys.
Two strangers in the bright light. Wish I knew you. I wish I knew you. Oh, wish I knew you when I was young.
So, wish I knew you, wish I knew you. So is it, oh, I wish I knew you when I was young?
Wish I knew you. Oh, wish I knew you when I was young.
Hey, Mike. Is it possible to put any more blues in there? Is it possible?
There's like an electric synergy around a group of people with a common goal and a positive attitude to make this happen. So I'm having the time of my life.
We've found these people who can coexist in such tight quarters for so long, because that's, to me, that's the biggest pitfall. It's just, I don't know, somehow we've managed to keep the family together so far.
The culmination of us creating something bigger than ourselves. And it's the magic that we tap into when we're in the same room doing it together.
You know, our band is called the Revivalists, and there's a lot of connotation with that. With our musical backgrounds in New Orleans and in Muscle Shoals and in everywhere else, you know, we're really trying to learn from the people and the history that's come before us.
Do it now, my baby. Come on.
right, we got that one. Cool. Done.
Moving on.
That's the one.